And welcome to my Let's Play of Mass Effect Andromeda. I am the RPG Chick. And how am I playing this now for people who are watching this? Well, before the 21st, because Mass Effect Andromeda is coming out on March 21st. Well, there is a 5-day preview, trials, whatever you want to call it. If you have EA access for Xbox or Origin access for PC. Sorry, PlayStation players, it's very unfair. But anyway, I'm playing this on the morning of the 16th. And I am actually, the game is technically still downloading. I'm a little more than halfway done, but you can start playing before it's done downloading, which I hope will be okay. If it starts stuttering and stuff and being unruly, I'm going to have to cut it off until, I guess, tomorrow or later today on the 16th. A few things. As you can see, Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3, if you guys want to watch that, I've just spent the last year playing these three games. I'm a late starter, but I'm now caught up, and I love the series very much. It's now my favorite franchise, quote-unquote. I'm cautiously optimistic about this game, which I'll get into in a minute. I'm playing this blind, so no spoilers, please. I've never played this before. The only thing I know is the basic, you know, you've traveled to the Andromeda Galaxy 600-something years into the future. The year is 2819? I don't know. It's far ahead. If you really, I think it's 2819, but I'll put it in the description, of course. And so, other than that, I know a few of the characters. I haven't even read their bios, because I don't want to know that much. Thank you. I don't plan on playing multiplayer, just through the single-player campaign. So the first 10 hours you can play, but some of them, if you want to play all 10 hours, have to be multiplayer. Only some of the single-player campaign is available. I don't know how much. But I will play at least, well, as much as I can, or 2 to 3 hours of it. So either one. I would like to thank my Patreon supporters, Patreon patrons, Joey Forsman, Meerkat, Sam White, Aaron Hopkinson, and Josh Atkinson. Thank you so much, guys. Really means a lot to me. And even if you guys don't support me on Patreon, it means a lot to me. So likes, comments, views, just general support. Thanks so much. Anyway, links and everything like that, Patreon, Facebook, Twitter, what have you, are in the description, of course. And what else? Right, I am still getting over a cold at this time, so my voice might sound a little bit nasally. Sorry. The more I talk, the more nasally it seems to get sometimes. Still getting over everything, so my voice is generally a little easier to listen to. So anyway, as far as this game, my thoughts on this, the lack of a story worries me. The lack of a story that they've released kind of worries me that there's not going to be much of one. Either that, or there's going to be plenty of story, and they're just leaving it, you know, hush-hush for us to find out for ourselves, which is what I hope. And the lack of a pause feature to, you know, enter commands and basically take, you know, a tactical approach and, you know, just sit back and think, well, okay, they're over there and I can do this and that. That's not in this game. They've taken that out, so it's way more action-y, and I really like the pause feature, so I'm bummed about that. Anyway, I really haven't played. We're completely blind this time. The only thing I did was make a character and mess with my settings. And that's it. I haven't even started anything. So as far as settings, tutorials, aim assist, auto level, no, contextual. This is all set. These guys were set. Squad mates were often gameplay and conversations. I switched it to off in conversations. If it gets hard for me to tell who's who, I'm going to switch back. Subtitles, of course, we have. Field of view, I didn't mess with. Let me guys, let me know if you have anything regarding field of view, as people are very opinionated about it. Doesn't really bother me either way, so... Yeah, I did move something, but I moved it back. Well, whatever. Controls. Key bindings, right? I didn't mess with that. Invert Y... I didn't even look here. Wow, they have sensitivities separate for the vehicles? Sprint controls. We're gonna toggle that. Aiming. That'll hold. Subject to change at any time, guys. So most or all of this episode is just going to be me creating my character, which I feel is safe because the game was stuttering before when I was, going through any kind of animation, which is basically just the planet that we saw in the beginning. Sustained power controls? Require a button to be held down while in use. Toggled on and off. Huh. Vibration. I'm playing with a keyboard and mouse, so vibration, no. I'm gonna leave everything else the way it is right now. Probably gonna change stuff. Configuration. Yes. Ow! So you mean gamepad configuration. Blasto? Blasto! Alright. This should say gamepad configuration. Key bindings. Now I use a tactical board. I don't even use a keyboard, so that's why... Wait. The thing... Okay, hold on. Okay. The thing... I don't know. I have a picky motherboard with USB controllers. They wiggle or they're loose or something, who knows. So that thing got undone. Wait. Damn it. Yeah, that is space. Evade. Middle mouse button. I'm not completely sure what that is. Mantle? Melee, I think this is F, yes. I don't plan on meleeing very much. Power one, okay. So everything's gonna be hotkeyed. Or at least three powers are gonna be hotkeyed. What else do we have? Reload. Control. Fire. Tight aim. Shifts. That. This might be boring to you guys, but I'm just like, I don't know. I am exploring this stuff. Left squad made orders, right squad made orders. Scanner. I didn't want to change that to that. Is there a map? I don't know all of what there is. Skips conversation line. Codex. So we can get to Codex without going out to the main menu. I like that. I do like that. It's been so long since I had Codex mapped to something. Game menu. Escape? Well, I pressed escaped. I pressed escape and it says H. Or it was already set to H. This isn't like H. We have an inventory again. So that'll be inventory. Journal. Ah. Wait. This is map. Okay, we really got... Do I have to press a key to get to all this stuff? There's a lot of things. Favorites, scoreboard, yeah. This is for multiplayer. Whoops. I'm gonna be messing with this more, guys. Evade is middle mouse button. I guess it's like a dodge or something. Power 1, 2... I'm just gonna put it here. Now, keep in mind, I'm not pressing keys on my keyboard. This is a tactical board, which... I don't know. If you Google Thrustmaster tactical board, you'll see what it looks like. Pretty neat. I like it. It's like a cross between a keyboard and a joystick, like a gamepad, rather. Interact will be that. Basic interact. So they really, like, really simplified things as the series went on. Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3 gradually simplified things, and now they've expanded out. With, you know, it's, at least this part, it doesn't seem like it's so much of a console. What do you call it? Console port. Left squad mate. I'm probably really going to have to use this more than often. Both squad mate. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna do that. I probably won't remember what I've keyed in because everything's so much here. Scanner. Scanner execute. Execute the scanner. Kill it. Narrative action. Look at POI. Mission tracker. Put Codex there, game menu all the way down there. I could just escape out for that though. Journal. Okay. I don't even know and I don't want to mess with things anymore. Okay, but I need you. Did it keep it? Yeah. Okay. So, okay, back. Audio, I haven't messed with anything here. You could go to surround sound and not, and dynamic range I didn't mess with. The sound in this menu sounds rather low, so I haven't messed with anything. Subtitles, of course, on. Language, of course. English. Video output. Now this is interesting. It actually knows, it recognized which kind of monitor I have. So now you guys know what kind of monitor I have. It's not the best, but it's what I could afford on top of the computer, which I bought at the same time. VSync. This I've never seen. Frame buffer format. Sorry guys, just coughing and stuff, so I mute the mic when I do that. I'm guessing 64 bits is better, so I changed it to that. And yeah, I'm not really sure. Yeah, so this is my graphics card and my GPU memory. I don't even know what HDR mode is. And I tried to look this up, frame buffer settings and stuff. I couldn't find anything. Because I was only doing like a quick search for it. Graphics, online. Yeah, nothing. Okay, so multiplayer, no. Quick start, no. Yeah, this is my old channel name. Well, this is my old name, and it still is my channel name. Customized character. Yeah, it was really stuttery before. That's better. I guess because it's loaded more of it. Or maybe changing the frame rate buffer helped. I don't know. I did change that. It was set to the other setting, the 32-bit. Okay, so we are changing this face. I am very sorry, but I cannot stand the default Sara Ryder face. I'm very sorry. So, I'm going to keep her name as Sara Ryder because I think they will say her name's Sara if you, you know, keep it as Sara. But she's going to look very different. So, these people are like, I wouldn't say they're unattractive, but it seems like they're caught in the worst light possible. They're all like, you know, they look all greasy and stuff. It's not very flattering. You know what's cool about her though? I love this. The cornrows with the tattoo like that. Like the Matrix tattoo. But we're not choosing that one. I'm gonna start with this one. She's gonna end up looking a little bit different. And we can go like that. Yeah, we can't choose custom. I think we have to choose this first. It's weird the way this is set up, but it... Oh, what? Nope. That was cool, though, the way that happened. Okay, select. I want to select. Resetting will discard... Yes. Okay, so now I think we can go... No. Custom. I don't know. We can't seem to get... custom now. Okay. Okay, I think once you select this stuff, it goes custom. Okay. It's just weird. Okay, so the skin tone... This is what I was messing with. I'm making her skin tone... not completely pale, but just whiter. I don't know. I'm not messing with the brow at all. The cheek. Cheekbones. There's only a little bit of cheekbones. So this is more cheek... Wait. Oh, okay. That's better. Cheek width height. Yeah, just gonna... What if I... Oh, that's a little better. Okay. Now make sure to look from all angles, because I don't want her to look freaky like my Shepard in Mass Effect 2, I believe. Was it Mass Effect 1 or 2? Her nose was all messed up, and you couldn't see it unless you turned to the side, and I didn't turn to the side and look. Eye, height, and depth, width, yeah, fine. Mouse. We're going more like this. Nose size. Oh God. What the hell? I didn't even click anything. Wait. Right? No skull looking. That's a little weird, isn't it? Oh. Wait. Is it resetting every time I click on it? Oh, because I'm just clicking. I'm clicking and it's moving. Wait. I wish I could move the head up and down. You can't, apparently. Oh, this is okay. And yes, I'm changing the hair. A little bit, anyway. Okay. So here, yeah, hair. Speaking of which. So you've got different hairstyles. You've got barely any hair. So chopped off, my God. It looks like someone chopped that off, like when she was asleep. Like she was drunk, extremely drunk, and someone just chopped her hair off. So this is very short. Oh, it doesn't want to move. See that? I think that's what I currently have. So this is... That's a more cute pony. And look, it actually... Didn't it move a little? Yeah, it moves a little. I just don't like the front, though. It's very... I don't know. The hairline is messed up. You're okay here, but then all of a sudden, whomp, it's forward. No. And this... Total rocker. Pat Benatar, baby! Alright, so this is with the one with the cornrows. I kind of like that. You know, it's like a... I don't know. It's pretty badass, but... this is okay. I do like the way that... Oh, look at that. That really does move nicely, doesn't it? It clips with it softly. Look at that. Alright. Well, I suppose they're still making improvements. I don't know. Frostbite engine here, guys. Frostbite engine... That's pretty cool. I don't know. I don't think it goes with her face, is what it is. That's, you know, basically pretty good. So, we got that one, and we got this one. I kind of like this, but I don't like the way her eye is so covered. Right? Doesn't seem like it would be good for... Her nose is really red. I wonder if I can fix that. That might be just part of the general complexion, though. You know? On second thought... I might just go with that? Well, believe it or not, I might just... Eh... There's not enough hairstyle choices, is what I think. Like Butchie in the back. Butchie in the back, Cutie in the front. You know what? Why not? I'll just go with that. Now the hair colors. You got hair colors like this. You know, if you really want to. I mean, you're hanging out with a bunch of aliens, you're not gonna really look that weird compared to them. Speaking from a human perspective, of course. Little Ashley coming out there. You know, I decided not to go with these reds, because they were, like, insane. Plus, it does not go with her skin tone, at least that's the way I have it right now. I think I'm gonna lighten the skin tone a little bit more, but we're gonna go more of a natural red. Because I'm always red. But she is definitely going to look different than my shepherd. Very... Yeah, a tiny bit darker. Okay. the eyes. Now this is weird. Actually, it's pretty cool. You move this reticule or whatever the hell you'd call it to change the colors inside. I've seen things like this on like color pickers and stuff, or like making your own logo and things like that, but never, I don't think I've ever seen it in the game. Then again, there's a lot of modern games that I have not played. So could just be me. But that's the outer, right? And then you can make the inner. Which, if you want to match the colors, it's almost impossible. Because you see how these things move? I'm literally moving my mouse tack, as smoothly as I can. So this thing needs to be either bigger or something. Because it's really hard to, or at least have a text field where you can enter the number. That'd be cool. So they've made a lot of, like, good changes, I think. They just, there's room for improvement. Now, where did I have this thing? Somewhere around here? See, that's the problem. I do want to kind of have it be the same. So I got six, this is 1,000, same as what, 693 and 56. 684 and zero. 684 and zero. Really close though with this. So wait. 60. Can I match it? Oh, I'm going back to 680. Oh, that's supposed to be 1,000. That's really close, isn't it? So it's the same color. Inside and out. It's a little pinkish though. I don't know. Still looks pink. Wait, because it moved back. Funky! I like it. So that. And then, yeah, this is going to be all just customizing, guys. Sorry, guys, if you want to see, you know, gameplay, but it's probably best that I don't record it right now because we're still downloading and it's it could be choppy. Eyeliner style opacity. The only problem with this is most of our eye is covered here. eyeliner style. So it's interesting. We've got, okay. You got wings. I didn't look at this. Yeah, no. So you got different kinds of wings. You got this wing, which I guess is a, you know, I don't know, like a wave, and you've got this wing, which is more of an Egyptian style. That's I don't know. I like that. I like this one. I like this one. It's a little more, you know. Oh, the island. Yeah, we're gonna have it all the way up. Okay. I keep clicking that and changing. Eyeliner color we have down here. I'm gonna leave that. Can I make that more black? This is black. I guess this is as black as we go. Technically, it should be zero. All should be zero, but I can't seem to do that. I figure we're just dragging the corner. Every time it gives me... close enough. It gives me a different number every time, even though I'm dragging it, trying to drag it to the extreme corner there. Strange. Eyeshadow style. Oh, we did that. Oh, eyeshadow. Never mind. Eyeshadow. This is interesting. So you've got the basic style here. You've got just blotching all over the place, like really artistic. Yeah, yeah, it's a little Picasso, you know. And this is like really, really minimal. Like it looks like only the lids, maybe, or nothing. It is a little bit on there. Yeah, no. This is the PB style. I really. She's kind of cute from the trailers. That she looks even younger than Liara. She looks like she's like, I don't know. She looks like she's basically... Like, Liara is basically a teenager during the game. Mass Effect 1 through 3. Especially 1. I think she does look a little younger in 1. But, it's just PB's like, I don't know, like 10. She's, I don't think I'm going to be, romantically interested in her, so. Yeah, funky. So, which surprises me. You'd think I'd go for the Asari every time, but in this case, no. So, can I make it? Should I make it dark? You know what? Yeah, let's keep it like that. And now the color. The color is bluish. Wait, I want to move this thing. This thingy ding. Oh, God. I just happened to look at her face. It's a little much. Wait. You can't see that side. Babylon 5 theme song. Well, one of them. Lipstick style. Basically, none. And then some of that, and just part of it, and... Wait. I went all the way. How'd that happen? I want to scroll through them. Yeah, funky. This is like... Wait. If you go like this... Yeah, you can really say what it is. Yeah. That's gotta be really difficult. Well, technology, right? I guess you could just... a machine does it. Yeah, someone doesn't have to put on makeup. I kinda like that shade. It's a lot of makeup, though. You know, that is a lot of makeup. So... I don't know. Yeah, I ended up choosing this with the opacity down, and I didn't notice it was like this. And then I changed it, and, you know, all of a sudden, I'm Harlequin or something. Let's, not be freaky. Let's... wow, it really gets opaque quickly. That's a lot of makeup, you know? I don't know. It's just... Alright. And... I'm moving it when I don't want to. Let's see... We're like hyper gloss. Can you imagine that? That's out of control. But we don't want the lips to look all dry and stuff either, so... you know what? Here. Now that I can see the lips better... I'm... finding I don't like them very much. Mouth... Now what's interesting is we don't have different kinds of mouths. We can only change the thickness, height, depth, and width. So I am going to make it... See, I don't like the way it looks higher on that side than that. So, No. We need a little... Whoop, depth. Oh, frick, no. No, oh, now she's moving. I'm trying to move this. Oh, look at that. Okay. Yeah! That's cute. I think she's rather cute. The nose I messed with. Okay. Now what else? Blush style. Little blush. We're turning the opacity really up so you guys can see. Freaky! Actually, once I hit this, Oh, it didn't change, right? No. Right. Okay, so just pretend this isn't green. You look like you have scales, lines and sand, and that's basically it. You have four different choices. Now, blush color. I really want traditional... Ah! Stop that. You could really make your character look so outlandish that the enemy really should just be completely like, what the hell? And then you could just mow him down. Blush style. Opacity. Alright. I'll make it less. Because she has a lot of makeup on. Right? She looks better though. She needs earrings. That's like this. Like dew is like great for earrings, but you know that's not practical. I mean, we're not in the military, but still, we're gonna be fighting and stuff and dying and all that fun stuff. Oh, I didn't even look here. Scars and tattoos, right? So I'm not gonna choose any. I'm just gonna show you guys what they are because you might be curious. Wait, yeah. Oh, the poor girl. Oh my God, it looks painful. You got one here. Ah. Scar tissue. Yeah. What? It's a... Oh my God, she got run over by a tire. Freaking Mako, Trounded, or Nomad, whatever you call it. Ah, the Nomad ran right over her face. That's like... Looks like her hair covers some of that, maybe. Oh God, she got scratched. Oh, that's like, yeah, over there. Good thing it didn't take her eye out. We got all scratched up here. Scratched. This must be on her forehead, I guess. Oh my God. They have so many. Ow. It almost looks like the muscles in her cheek. That's freaky. I mean, I can... Ow. I can kind of see, you know, if you really want to make a tough kind of war hero, I could see how you'd... Like, badass character. I could see how you'd want to do that. But, not I. Yeah, no. Scuffed up road rash and crap. Zero. Zero of that. And no intensity. Just make sure. Tattoos. Wow. Oh, that's there. Okay. Well, I'm back to Scar. Wait. Move. Okay. Is that where... Oh, on this side. It's really, you know... Can I hit the mount? I can hit arrows, okay. The only problem then is I'm going... I don't know where that tattoo is. Probably somewhere else. Covered by hair. That's on that side, and on that side. Oh, look at that. Cool. Wait, I'm back to that. That's on that side. Freaky! Yeah, I'm not taking any of these either. Just showing you guys. And I'm curious for myself. That's kind of cool. You know what? Maybe. No. Alright. Yeah, you know? Okay. Sorry, guys. Got loud. I'm getting excited. I don't know. Select. Oh, wait. We can do tattoo color. You know I like the color as is. I could do more bluish, greenish. I kind of like the way it is. So we done. I think we're done. We're like 40 minutes. We're like 40 minutes into the damn thing. Okay. I think I just want to make the skin tone maybe a little less. Not that much. So what do you think? I think she's cute, and she doesn't look anything like Sara Ryder. Win! Alright, confirm. Now this made me laugh. Customize history. Choose the gender of the legendary Commander Shepard, first human specter, and the hero of the Citadel. So I had already changed it to female Shepard. So I'm guess they just refer to, you know, oh, Commander Shepard, she was a great war hero. Or whatever. Or she is a great war... Well, they're going to say she was, because how can she still be alive 600-something whatever years later? Alright, so... So this is what I look like? Okay. Pretty cool, pretty cool. Okay. Oh! I can customize the twin... I didn't even see this here before. Now choose the name, which I'm going to keep the same. I really don't want to, but if you keep it as Sara, they say Sara. Otherwise, I guess they say Ryder? I don't even know. So, escape out. I'm not going to mess with him that much. I really don't care. I mean, I guess he looks fine. I don't know. He's going to look more like the guy... Wait, wait, wait. Yeah, she's... Okay. I just want to make sure I'm not changing her. So, yes. So where's... What does he look like? Oh, God. Like this, but without that hair. Is fine. Oh wait. So I go into hair, okay. Just... What different hairstyles can you pick? Oh crap! We can make him look a little cool. Why not, right? He still appears in the game, you know, even though you're not playing him. He appears as your twin. Who's still in the game? I don't know why. This looks like so like Backstreet Boys or something. Oh, God. Okay, that's where we were. Now, I'm changing the color. Yeah. Make him... Where is he? No. Yeah. Kinda looks cool. That... not mullet, sideburns is what I'm talking about. No. Now I'm getting picky. He has the frickin' sideburns. Maybe you change that on the cheeks. Cause I'm like, he has it with every hairstyle. No. Hair color... I'm just gonna mess with this a little bit. Yeah. Facial hair type. Oh God. So this doesn't... Oh, it does change that. It's part of... Holy crap, Mountain Man. It's part of the... No. Probably just gonna have this little, yeah, just a little bit. Alright, other than that, I mean, I'm not gonna give him eyeliner and stuff, and... What if I give him the same tattoo? Which is... Yeah, they have matching tattoos, that's what it is. Alright, so that's what we're gonna do. Same color, matching tattoos. Hair color. I mean, whatever, it's fine. How about... Oh, eyes? Color is here. Yeah, let's give him kind of really deep blue eyes or whatever. Deep blue eyes. Sure! Why not? Alright, so... I'm sorry, those eyebrows are just ridiculous. Brow height or depth? We can't change the way they're like... freaky like that? Brow. I guess not. Well, he's fine. He's fine. Whatever. Eyes. Nose. Skin tone. He's got no skin tone. Wait, it changed when I went in. Oh, crap, no. Give him a little skin tone. Yes. Confirm. Okay, now the history. Oh. Wait. Choose training. Okay. So, you guys can pause this if you want to read everything. Security has your concussive shot. Turbo charge. There's a boost to fire rate and thermal clip. Combat fitness. Kind of reminds me of like a Garrus type character. And biotic, whoa, what happened? Biotic is probably what I'm going to be choosing. Throw, singularity, barrier. I didn't use barrier much. I had something like barrier, didn't we? Oh, I had an option to take barrier in Mass Effect 3. I didn't mess with it. Technician. Why is it doing that? Look at this. I'm going to click technician. Click. It brings me out. I guess because I've chosen it, right? Okay. I just really used to just clicking something and then going down here and going, you know, select back or whatever. Leader. Team leader, natural leader. In the Alliance military. Energy drain. Annihilation. It's one of my favorite words. Shifting aura of Mass Effect fields around you to slowly damage nearby foes. So like a damage over time, but you know, near you, close proximity. Team support, specialized technology to bolster survivability. That's pretty neat. So squad powers, right? Something that, you know, applies to the entire squad, which we've seen, you know, in previous games. So technician has overload. Right, overload, invasion, hack into, so this is like your tally kind of thing, your tally powers here. Team support, survivability of your entire squad. That's the only one with the, they couldn't fit it in one. So you have to scroll with just that one. Scrapper, charge, right? Remember charge. Combat fitness. Operative. Tactical cloak. Become invisible for a short duration. I kind of like that. Gain a large damage bonus when you break cloak to attack. So it's a sneak attack. Basically, you're a roguish type character, at least with that power. Combat fitness. And then... see, I don't get this. It's your starting power. Tactical cloak. But it's also an unlocked skill, tactical cloak. Both? Maybe improved tactical cloak? Then they should put that there, improved tactical cloak. So I'm going to put Bionic. I'm going to be Bionic this time. Because I love Throw and Singularity. I hope we get more powers on top of that. They just don't say, you know. Oh god. I double-clicked it. Stay the same. Choose training. Biotic. Select. Now you go back. Confirm and start game. next episode, guys. Sorry. But this is quite a long episode as it is. So yeah, I'm ready to go. I'm raring to go. I'm a female. What? Wait, it says technician. Okay. Don't touch anything. Female Biotic, Sara Ryder. History of Female Shepherd. Both custom appearances. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you tomorrow, which would be the 17th, if you're watching currently, for actual stuff. Just be advised, I am not going to be playing any multiplayer. I'm going to play the story until, you know, I either run out of time, and it's now the 21st, which I can carry my game over anyway, or I'm going to play the story until I'm out of story, and then we'll have a couple days off or something. I don't know how much story we can play. But in any case, I look forward to checking out, and I hope you guys, you know, didn't hate this episode too much, and I hope to see you in the next episode. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.